Somebody asked where they go to see the class, so I'm just going to send that email, that text very quickly. If you are watching me send this text, then roll out your mat, gather your props, a block and a blanket if you have one, and a strap. Okay, message sent. Student text me earlier this week about having a torn meniscus, and I told her that I would look that up. So I did look that up, and I found some enlightening material online about how to promote knee health through yoga. And as long as I've been teaching yoga, I learned some things that I didn't know. And it was kind of jarring because I thought, oh, maybe I have not been using the best practices for knee health, even though I have a long-standing knee injury myself. So that brought up a lot of things, that feeling of like, you know, somewhat a feeling of inadequacy or a feeling of, I should have known these things. That's kind of a theme that I want to go on today. And it reminded me of a Bob Dylan lyric that I really love, which is from the song My Back Pages, and it's the chorus is or the refrain is, I was so much older then, I'm younger than that now, and made me think about how through certain learning experiences we can kind of feel more, you know, we feel a little bit vulnerable and, you know, younger in this way. Like, as you learn more, you kind of realize that you know less. But that can be, you know, in having that experience, you kind of re-expand, like you're reopened to new experiences and new possibilities. So, I am going to teach today with some of this new information in mind to the best of my ability. And I also had a request for more flow. So those are two things we're gonna do today. So without further ado, let's come to a comfortable cross-legged seat. And with this idea of focus on the knees and the legs, consider coming to your cross-legged seat without using your hands. So just using your legs to come into that seat. So cross your legs once, look at which leg is on the bottom, extend your legs out again, and then cross your legs with the opposite leg underneath. If you need to use your hands, do, but attempt to do this without using your legs. Okay, settle down through your hips, through your sits bones, place your hands on your thighs, and close your eyes. Arrive in this moment on your mat with your breath. So perhaps you have already begun to establish your home yoga practice. If that is the case, you might be aware of the energy that you have access to in this space, in this time. So simply by coming into this conscious seat for practice, there are certain things that just start to happen more automatically. So do you notice your breath deepening? You might automatically become aware of the connection between your body and the earth. If not, consciously turn your attention to the spaces where your body is touching the surfaces beneath you. Root down through those spaces visualizing roots growing from your body through the foundation of whatever building you might be in, down into the earth. And then from that energetic connection, lift up out of your waistline, grow tall along your spine. Shrug your shoulders up towards your ears, lengthening the sides of the body, and then looping the shoulder blades together behind your heart. Collarbones broad, chest lifted. Release the weight of your forearms down so the shoulder blades slide down the backside of your chest. Tilt your chin parallel to the floor. Ease the sides of your neck back. Create a tone in your upper abdomen by drawing your front, left and right, lower ribs into a central point and then easing that point towards your spine. Feel the air of the room against your skin. Feel the edges of your being commingling with the air all around you so that you feel your edges soften. You might even experience that as the sense of an aura or a glow about you. Notice any inadvertent tension in the face, places where you unconsciously may hold expression, whether that be a furrow of the brow, a clench of the jaw, purse of the lips, holding the tongue to the ceiling of the mouth. Scan the face and neutralize expression. As you turn your senses inward, slow, deep breath in and out through the nostrils. Begin Ujjayi Pranayama, triumphant uprising breath, by drawing in a contraction at the back of your throat. Let the aspirant sound of this breathing act as a soundtrack to this breath meditation. Drawing the awareness, the senses, into this interplay of the internal and the external. We'll do four rounds of box breath. And several options for this. You can continue using the contraction at the back of your throat to make that ujjayi sound throughout the box breath. I'm also going to give you the options of using bandhas here, so locks, the root lock at the end of the exhale by drawing in and up on the pelvic floor. And then as we inhale, we're going to hold the breath, and I invite you to engage Jalandhara Bandha by tucking the chin to the chest and drawing the throat in. To me, that has the experience of bringing awareness to the upper back and filling the uppermost regions of the lungs. Okay, so those are the options. We're going to do a 4-count inhale, a 4-count hold, possibly with the Jalandhara Bandha, a 4-part exhalation, a 4-count exhalation, and a 4-part hold with the breath empty and drawing in and up, Mula Bandha root lock. Okay, without further ado, exhale to empty your lungs. And we'll inhale for 1, 2, 3, 4. Fill and hold Jalandhara Bandha, chin to the chest. 1, 2, 3, 4. Lift the chin, exhale. 1, 2, 3, 4. Hold the breath empty, draw in and up, Mula Bandha. 1, 2, 3, 4. Round two, inhale. 1, 2, 3, 4. Fill and hold, tilt the chin. 1, 2, 3, 4. With control, exhale. 1, 2, 3, 4. Empty the lungs and hold, Mula Bandha. 1, 2, 3, 4. Two more rounds with your own count. Upon completion of your four rounds of box breath, bring your palms together in front of your heart. As you press your palms in, widen out through your elbows and broaden across your collarbones. We will chant Om three times before beginning the moving practice. Exhale, empty the lungs. And inhale for the first of three Oms. Your palms to your thighs, then slowly lift your head as you open your eyes. Again, without using your hands, take your legs forward and then switch the cross of your legs. Take your right hand behind, left hand crosses to the right thigh. Inhale, grow tall, and exhale, revolve. Moving into a seated twist, considering shifting the inner body using the abdominal muscles from left to right. Moving your awareness up the spine from the low back, mid back, upper back, abdomen, front ribs, chest. Stay broad across your collarbone. And then eventually take the gaze over the left shoulder, keeping the chin parallel to the floor. Breathe deeply along the length of your spine, exploring space. And then easing, expanding into that space as you exhale. Left hand stays where it is. Right arm extends up along the right ear, reaching out of the right waistline. And then exhale, lean at an angle over the left thigh. Use your left hand to pull the left shoulder forward, opening your chest skyward. Keep the right hip rooting down. Breathe along the right side body. Again, notice any tension in the face, across the forehead, at the edges of the mouth and the jaw. Soften the face as you turn your attention to your right side. Inhale, come back through center, left hand behind, right hand crosses the left thigh. Inhale, growing tall, and exhale, beginning to revolve. So there is the possibility of using the hands here to create the revolution of the spine. Let's start without using the hands. How much can you just shift the upper body using the strength of the abdomen? Hug the left shoulder onto the back and then place the hands. So try to keep that engagement of the abdomen that you needed when you weren't using your hands, even once your hands are placed. Chin parallels the floor as the spinal revolution moves up from the earth, up through the crown of the head. Again, engage the breath to deepen the experience of the pose, to deepen the internal experience, and perhaps even to deepen the expression of the shape. Okay, left arm reaches up along the left ear, lift up out of the left waistline, and exhale, slowly lean the upper body over the right thigh at an angle. Keep the left hip rooting down, and then again, consider using the abdomen to revolve the right ribs forward. So instead of just relying only on this pressure of the right hand against the thigh, first utilize or try to use the low back, the abdominal muscles to revolve the right ribs forward, and then you can bring the hand back to the thigh. Just an experiment for today. Lengthen out through the left fingertips, root through the left outer hip. Look up, soften the face, breathe awareness along the left side body. And inhale, come back to center. Hand down and move forward into a tabletop position. Plant your wrists below your shoulders, spread your fingers and your palms, knees are hip width distance, and let's move into our cat and cows. Inhale, belly and chest down, tailbone and gaze, lift, and exhale, round the spine, chin to chest, tailbone towards the floor, belly button towards the sky, push the earth away to dome the upper back. Cat pose, inhale back to cow. Explore the range of motion of your spine. And you might notice, especially if you're doing this early in the morning, that this range of motion might be slowly awakened just over the course of a few breaths. So especially if you're working, you're approaching this practice early in the morning, it's good to ease into this slowly. Let's return to a neutral spine, shoulders over the wrists, rooting down through the knuckles. And we're gonna take the gaze forward and down as we lift the right leg straight up and back. Knee and toes point downward. And we're gonna take the left arm forward, finding this balance on the left knee and the right hand, reaching forward with the left fingertips and staying firm with the right leg, pushing into the space behind us. So last week I introduced the idea of this pose is there's the right leg is in the past, the left arm, the gaze is reaching to the future, and in the present, you have this stability, this strength at your center. So reach forward, reach back, and then we're gonna exhale to bring the elbow to the knee, knee to the elbow. Inhale, exhale, curl in, knee to elbow. Inhale, reach out, exhale in, inhale out, exhale, curl in, inhale, reach out, and then release the hand down, release the knee down. So I noticed that was a little, there's a little bit of pain in the left knee and the grounded knee. So for the second side, if you experience that too, you might bring some padding underneath the right knee. Inhale, the left leg lifts. Knee and toes point down so the hips remain at an even height. Tone the muscles of your left leg. So engage the knee, or as I was reading on this website this morning, this idea of knee lock or Janu Bandha. So the kneecap lifts with the toning of the muscles around the knee. Reach the right arm forward. Again, this idea of one foot in the past gaze and reaching to the future, and in the center there's this stability and awareness, strength from which to expand out. And then exhale, knee in, elbow in. Inhale, reach. Let's do five of these. I didn't count the first side. Exhale, curl in. Inhale, reach. Exhale, curl. Inhale, reach. Three. Exhale, curl. Inhale, reach. Four. Exhale, curl. Inhale, reach. Five. Okay, back to our table. Place the left hand in front of the face, right hand to the back of your skull. Inhale, open the chest to the right wall. Look up, reach up with the right elbow. Exhale, curl in. Inhale, open right. Exhale, curl in two. Inhale, open right. Exhale, curl in three. Let's do ours, another set of five. Inhale, open right. Exhale, curl in. Last one, the first side. Inhale, open. And exhale, curl in. Right hand below the face. And let's take the left hand to the back of the skull. Inhale, open left. Look up, point up with the left elbow. Exhale, shoulder blades apart, elbow towards the wrist. Inhale, open. Exhale, curl two. Inhale, open. Exhale, curl three. Inhale, open. Exhale, curl four. Inhale, open. And exhale, curl in five. Okay, back to tabletop. Let's take the knees back about 6 to 8 inches. Tuck the tailbone towards the ceiling like you're doing cow pose in the low back. Look forward, reach the chin forward as you bend your elbows straight back, lowering the chin and chest to the floor at about the same rate, if possible. Elbows in, shoulder blades on the back, tailbone way up in the air. And now slide forward onto your belly. Point your legs back, point your toes back, tone the muscles of your legs again. So as you point through your toes, I want you to engage the muscles around your knees so that your kneecaps lift towards the front of your hips and lift up off of the floor. Lengthen back to your tailbone, scoop your tailbone forward. Draw your lower abdomen in and up. Elbows in, shoulder blades on the back. Inhale, curl the chin and chest up away from the floor. Again, starting out without using the hands here. So little baby cobra, look ma, no hands. You can lift your hands up off the floor using the strength of just the back body, just the upper back to lift the chest, open the chest. Okay, now we're gonna start to slowly push weight down into the hands, pull the heels of the hands back to engage the shoulder blades together behind the heart, collarbones broad, chest lifted, legs toned, kneecaps lift, toes point back, lengthen the tailbone, draw the lower abdomen in and up, and then exhale, we're gonna come all the way back down to the floor. Tuck the toes, lift the knees, again, Janu Bandha, this idea of locking the legs. So it's not thrusting the knees back, but it's engaging the space around the knees so the kneecaps lift up and pull away from the floor. Lengthen the tailbone back, draw in and up on the lower abdomen, shoulder blades on the back. Exhale, push up into a plank position. Inhale in the plank, shoulders over the wrist. Exhale back. Downward facing dog. Attempt not to adjust your stance too much. I know I am in the habit of doing so, and I'm trying to slowly, gradually break that habit of shortening my dog every time. Okay, explore your dog. You might walk out the feet, bending one knee, reach out the heel towards the floor. If a prolonged dog is not in your practice, if it gives you vertigo, if it makes you nauseous, then you can also use these same arm and shoulder stretches in an extended child's pose. So we're doing sets here. So today we're gonna do five push-ups, two sets of five push-ups. Inhale, come forward to plank. Exhale, lower down with control. Inhale, press up. Exhale, lead with the hips back to down dog. That's one. Inhale, come forward.
Exhale, lower down with control, possibly coming to your knees to keep form. Inhale, push up. Exhale, if you're on your knees back, child's pose, otherwise downward facing dog. Inhale, forward. Exhale, lower. Inhale, press. Exhale, back. Three. Two more first set. Inhale, forward. Exhale, lower. Inhale, press. Exhale, back. Four. Last one. Inhale, forward. Exhale, lower. Inhale, press. Exhale, back. Down dog. Bring your right foot towards center as you reach your right leg back, and bring your left foot towards center as you reach your right leg back and lift it up. So let's practice this lifting the leg. So lift up, knee and toes point down, pushing out through the heel, bring it down. Inhale, lift it up. Exhale, lower it down. Inhale, lift up, three. Exhale, lower down. Inhale, lift up, four. This can be done from a tabletop position as well. Exhale, lower down. Inhale, lift up, five. Look to the top of your mat and exhale, lunge your right foot between your hands. So come into a long stride with the knee over the heel. Hands can be on fingertips, fists, or even blocks on either side of your front foot. So if you do not have blocks, and if you are consistently doing a practice at home, I highly recommend the acquisition of blocks. And you can get in touch with me. I've got a good block source right now where I can get them on the cheap. So blocks are a good thing. Blocks are a good thing. Okay, sink your hips down and forward, right thigh parallels to the floor, and then bend your back knee towards the floor to get that sense of weightiness in the hips. Then lift through the back inner upper thigh to straighten and strengthen the back leg. Feel the feet on the floor. And today, really scissor the legs together. Emphasize the drawing of the right heel back and the pulling of the left foot forward, giving that strength, that stability, that contraction towards the center. Then lift up higher on your fingertips, or if you have them on your blocks, shoulders out of the ears. And then draw, as you draw in with the feet, draw back through the sides of the waistline to come up. Hands on the hips, hips and chest squared forward. Front knee bent to a 90 degree angle, lifting through the back inner upper thigh. Arms to your sides, shoulders roll back. Inhale, sweep the arms overhead. Exhale, open the upper body to the right. Inhale, center, five sets today. Exhale, open right. Inhale, center. Exhale, open right, three. Inhale, center. Exhale, open right, four. Inhale, center. Exhale, open right, five. Inhale, center. And exhale, hands back to the blocks or to the floor. Back to your lower lunge. Exhale, send the hips back, round the spine, forehead towards or to the knee. Inhale, come forward to your lunge. Exhale, send it back, round the spine. Inhale, come forward. Exhale, send it back. Inhale, forward. Two more. Exhale, send it back. Inhale, come forward. And exhale back, modified pyramid pose. Inhale, come forward into your lunge. Lift through the back inner thigh, left hand to the block or to the floor, right hand to your right thigh. Revolve your left ribs towards your right inner thigh. Look up, reach up. Stack the shoulders. Root down through the left knuckles. Reach out through the fingertips of the right hand. Either choose to stay here or revolve the chest open, using the strength of the abdomen to turn the left outer ribs skyward, right outer ribs earthward. And then look down, hand down, press back, downward facing dog. Walk out your dog. Inhale, come forward to plank. Exhale, lower down, knees, chest and chin to the floor. Inhale, curl up, cobra pose. Exhale, lower down. Tuck the toes, lift the kneecaps, lengthen the tailbone. Another exhale to push all the way up into plank. Inhale and plank. And exhale back, downward facing dog. Remember, we had another set of push-ups. Let's do those now. Inhale, come forward. Exhale, lower down. Inhale, press up. Exhale, hips lead you back, one. Inhale, forward. Exhale, lower. Inhale, press. Exhale, back, two. Inhale, forward. Exhale, lower with control. Inhale, push up. Exhale, back, three. Inhale, forward. Exhale, lower. Inhale, press. Exhale, back, four. Last one, best one. Inhale, forward. Exhale, lower. Inhale, press. And exhale. I don't know about best one, but it was the last one. Right foot towards the center, left leg lifts. Straight up and back, using the strength of the inner thigh. Lower the leg down, one. Inhale, lift the left leg. Exhale, lower it down. Push it evenly forward with the hands. Inhale, up. Exhale, lower. Inhale, lift the left leg. Exhale, lower. Last one. Inhale, reach up and back with the left leg. Look to the top of your mat. And exhale, lunge the left foot forward between your hands. Again, fingertips, fists, or blocks if you have them. So actually, I find for this particular focus, the blocks are nice because I find it easier to access that engagement of the legs with the chest a little higher up. Okay, so remember, we're gonna bring the left thigh parallel to the floor, bending the right leg temporarily to feel the weight of the hips. And then we're gonna activate the right inner upper thigh to lift the right thigh to straighten the right leg. And then emphasize that drawing in. Left heel pulls back isometrically, right foot draws forward. Janu Bandha, so this new idea of knee lock, pulling up on the muscles above the knee, lifting the kneecap. Okay, collarbones broad, hands to the hips, draw back through the sides of the waistline, square the hips and chest forward, keep lifting through the back inner thigh. As weight shifts forward, pull back into the left heel, draw the left heel towards the back of the mat. Arms to your sides, collarbones broad. Inhale, sweep the arms overhead. Exhale, open left. Inhale, legs steady, chest and arms forward. Exhale, open left, two. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, open the chest, left, three. Inhale, center. Exhale, open left, four. Inhale, center. Exhale, open left, five. Inhale, center, and exhale, hands back to frame the front foot. Inhale in the lunge. Exhale, push down through the left big toe. Janu Bandha on the left leg, knee lock. Pull the knee up, pull the hip back. Inhale to the lunge. Exhale, send the hips back, round the spine two. Inhale forward. Exhale, hips back three. Inhale forward. Exhale, hips back four. Inhale forward, and last one. Exhale, hips back five. Inhale forward. Right hand to the block or to the floor. Left hand to the left thigh. Keep lifting through the back inner thigh as you revolve the right ribs towards the left inner thigh. Stack the shoulders. Left arm up. Weight in the left. Weight in the right knuckles. Spread the fingers. Again, use the strength of your core to revolve your right abdomen towards center, your right ribs towards the center of your chest, opening your chest up towards the left wall. Choose to stay here or continue that revolution around the spine, wrapping the right ribs skyward, left ribs earthward, embracing the sky. And then hands back to the blocks or to frame the front foot as you step back into child's pose or downward facing dog. Push the hands down and forward, shift the hips up and back. Lift into the kneecaps. Inhale, come forward to plank. Exhale, lower down, knees, chest and chin, elbows in. Inhale, curl up, push the feet down, elbows in, collarbones broad. Exhale, lower down, breathe. Tuck the toes, tone the legs, lift the kneecaps, lengthen the tailbone. Exhale, push up. Inhale and plank. And exhale, send the hips back. DFD, downward facing dog. hands down and forward, hips up and back. Perhaps walking out your dog pose, bending one knee, reaching the opposite hip up and out, exploring the backs of the legs and the outer hips. Okay, if you've been with me the past several weeks, we've been consistently practicing our hops to the front of the mat. So we're gonna do that now. Oh boy, there's been a lot of, they're not sun salutations, but it's a lot of flowing with the breath. So we're gonna continue our flowing with the breath and some reps of hopping forward. So look between your hands, shift weight forward into your hands, lift onto your toes, bend your knees, draw back to the sides of the waistline. And as you exhale next, arrive at the top of your mat, lifting your hips high to land your feet with some amount of control towards the top of your mat. Okay, hop or step back. Down dog, inhale and down dog. Exhale, bend the knees, draw back to the side of the waistline, look between the hands and arrive at the top of your mat. Okay, three more. Hop or step back. Bend the knees, lift to the side of the waistline, look forward, push down with the hands. Exhale. And arrive. Okay, I trust you to do two more of these. I also trust you to not do two more if you're just feeling done with this. Okay. Okay, when you're done with your hops, come to the top of your mat in a forward fold with your knees and feet hip-width distance apart. Lift and spread your toes. Get a good connection between the soles of your feet and the floor before placing your toes back down. And then bend your knees as you let the upper body hang forward. Okay, take hold of opposite wrists, opposite forearms, or opposite elbows as you let the upper body flow forward, supported on the legs. You might make some subtle movements here. You might experiment with shifting weight forward in your feet to the knuckles of the toes. You might shift weight into the heels of the feet, to the insides of the feet, to the outsides of the feet, and then find some balance between each of those spots, inside, outside, front, back. You might sway the arms from side to side, shake the head, yes and no. Identifying tension along the back body, letting movement, letting energy flow through those spaces, creating relief, creating a sense of expression and expansion. So I like to call this waterfall pose for this idea of energy flowing up the backs of the legs as you inhale, pooling in the hips at the top of the inhale, and as you exhale, that energy cascades down the length of the spine, allowing the upper body to flow more freely forward. Release the shoulders, release the arms, release the head and neck. Now bring your fingertips to the floor in front of you, press down with the feet. Begin to lengthen along the backs of the legs. And again, as your legs start to straighten, start to lengthen, lift into your kneecaps. And you'll notice your ability to connect with this action will change in the different positions we take today. So for me, I know this is a challenging position to engage the knees in, to engage the Janu Bandha, to lift the kneecaps. Lengthen down through the crown of the head. The elbows might start to bend out to either side of the room as you explore the back body once again. This more activated upper body as the crown of the head reaches towards the floor. Lift your shoulders up away from your ears. With your next inhale, bring your palms to your shins. Straighten your elbows. Hug your shoulder blades together behind your heart. And then exhale, fold, perhaps even more deeply into yourself. Inhale, half lift, shoulders on the back. And exhale, fold forward. I'm in this, I've I'm stuck on this idea of five today, so three more. Inhale, half lift.
Exhale, fully commit
to folding into yourself, opening up the back body. Inhale.
Exhale, flow forward.
Last one, inhale.
Exhale, flow forward.
And inhale,
take the arms out, up and overhead, pushing down through the feet, lifting into the kneecaps, reaching up, looking up, palms touch, hands come through heart center as you exhale. Draw the arms to your sides as you come into Tadasana. So we're really reorienting here into this standing position after those prolonged forward folds. So recognize how that change of orientation might affect the energy you feel at this moment. Turn on those internal senses. Push down through the soles of the feet. You might notice the places in the feet where you feel more grounded, where you feel that you're bearing more weight. And then shift weight across the soles of the feet so you feel rooted at the base of your big toe, the base of your little toe, and each side of your heel. Again, Janu Bandha, this new concept that I'm introducing that I just read about this morning of knee lock. So lifting the kneecaps up, keeping a gentle bend in the knees, with being mindful of your personal, if you have a personal tendency to lock out your knees or hyperextend them. So feel that extension from your hips down through your feet. So when we really engage, when we really arrive in these poses, a pose as seemingly simple as mountain pose can really start to generate and turn on this energy. So again, let me recall that idea, that quote that I presented at the Bob Dylan quote that I presented at the beginning of class, the idea that I was so much older then, I'm younger than that now. So have you ever come to your practice, come to your mountain pose with a sense of knowing this pose, a deep intimacy, a conquest of this pose even? Can you look at this pose with fresh eyes, as though you barely know it at all, as though the secrets, the wonder of this pose are just beginning to unfurl to you, just beginning to expand? Okay, from here, sweep the arms overhead, look up as your palms touch. Exhale, gently bend your knees as you flow forward.
Release the head down. Inhale, half lift.
Exhale, fold in. Inhale, rise with the breath, flow up. Exhale, hands through heart center, arms to your sides, Tadasana. Again, inhale, reach up. Exhale, flow forward.
Inhale, lift halfway, shoulder blades on the back.
Exhale, flow in deep to yourself.
Inhale, rise.
Exhale, hands through heart center and arms to your sides. Once more with your own breath. Meet back in Tadasana, mountain pose. Okay, take the hands to the hips, root down through your left foot, and then we're just gonna swing the right leg forward and back. So there's a little bit of balance involved here. There's some reckless abandon with which we're swinging the leg forward and back. And we're gonna stop soon. Right, hands to the hips, and then bring the right leg forward. Again, Janu Bandha, lifting up on the kneecap, reach forward with the heels, hands on the hip, wrap the right outer hip down, lift the leg for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now, instead of bringing the leg down, keep the hands on the hips, and begin to lift the leg out behind you as you come forward into a warrior three pose. So take a moment to bend your right knee slightly, and then begin, or left knee slightly. As you bend the knee, then begin to push down into the left foot. Again, engage the left knee. Lift into the kneecap. Pull the left hip point up and back as you wrap the right outer hip down, right inner thigh lifts. Arms back, collarbones broad, arms out. Arms forward, look forward, reach forward. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hands to the hips, come back up. Woo! Do a little of this. Kick your butt. Kick your own butt a couple of times. Okay, and then the loop. One direction, keep it loose. Other direction. I'm sweating today. I don't know about you. I think I'm gonna turn on the fan. Okay. I bet you can guess what comes next. You have a second side. So step down with your right foot. Lift and spread the toes. Create a wide base with the right foot. Hands on the hips. Hands, swing that leg. Forward, back. Forward, back. So some balance here. Some reckless abandon. It's also kind of reminiscent. I look like I'm on an invisible Nordic track. Does anybody ever have one of those? I'm sure they're still around. We had one in my house growing up. It's fun to play on. Okay, bring the leg forward. So make sure your right knee and right toes are pointed forward. Bring your hands to your hips. Bring your left leg up. Push through the heel, pull back through the toes. Engage Johnny Bonda, lengthen the tailbone. Collarbones broad, spine long for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Swing the leg back. As the leg lifts parallel to the floor, bring your chest parallel to the floor. Bend the right knee. With the right knee bent, feel that connection between your right foot and the floor, and then begin to push down into the right foot. Lift into the right kneecap. Lift into the right outer hip. Revolve the left outer hip towards the floor. Left inner thigh lifts. Chest forward. Arms back. Collarbones broad. Arms out. Arms forward. Look forward. Reach forward. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Hands to hips. Push down to come up. Kick your butt. Thanks for being here, people who are here, whoever you are. Let me know. Give me a shout out either in the message board or afterwards. Okay, visible, invisible hula hoop. Keep it loose. Ankles and knees. Other direction. Okay, something that I want to talk about today. So keeping in the mind of like the whole more you learn, less you know vein of my perspective today, I wanted to approach awkward chair or what I call fierce chair a little bit differently today. I think by the flow that I kind of created that most of you are familiar with really emphasizes the rounding of the low back. But it doesn't use the strength of the legs to get down into the pose. So I really want to focus on using the strength of the legs to get deep into the posture. I have this block here. I don't know why I picked it up, but I'm tempted to use it. So I'm thinking I'm going to use this block, and I'm going to place my hands on either side of the block like so. Hard to find a place where you can see my hands. So I'm going to place my hands on either side of the block like so. I'm going to take the block forward. So do this with me. If you cannot stand with your feet together, base of the big toes touching, then I want you to get a block also to put between your thighs. Feet are pointing straight ahead. Okay, so bear with me. So arms forward. If you have the block, hold your block. Otherwise, just keep your hands shoulder width distance apart. Put some pressure on the block, pushing your hands in towards one another. Reach the fingertips forward and then plug your arms into your shoulder sockets. Reach forward, plug back. Lower ribs in and back. Then start to sweep your arms out, up, and overhead. Biceps back behind the ears. And now, reaching up, I want you to push down with the feet, squeeze the inner legs together or squeeze your block as you take a seat back into your chair. Oh boy. Weight shifts to the heels, waistline back, arms by the ears. If you're so inclined, look up. Sink deep down into your hips, and then push into your feet, stand up. One. And then we're not gonna do this necessarily with the breath. Squeeze the block, reach through the fingertips. Exhale, sink the hips down, squeeze the ankles and knees in. Waistline back. Inhale, come back up. Oh boy, this is hard. But I'm right here with you guys. Okay, lengthen up. Exhale, sink down. Inhale, lift up. Take a breather. Next, exhale, sink the hips down. Squeeze the ankles, squeeze the knees. Waistline back, arms back. Inhale, come back up. Last one, best one. Try to keep the knees together. Exhale, waistline back. Weight shifts to the heels, ankles and knees together. Pull the arms back. Inhale, come back up. And release that. Release that block, as I know you want to. Who's ready for a wide-legged forward fold? I know I am. So let's take the feet wide apart. You might step the heels to the back edge of your mat. Get those blocks again. Have them handy in front of you. Take the outer edge of the feet parallel to the short ends of your mat, perhaps turning your toes in slightly. Tone the muscles of your legs. So I often use this idea of pulling tight stockings up your legs, drawing skin to muscle, muscle to bone, also effectively creating that Janu Bandha, the knee lock, kneecaps lifted, hands on the hips, elbows back, shoulder blades together, tilt your chin and gaze up, lengthen along the front of the torso, and then as you exhale, hinge at the hips to bring the spine parallel to the floor. Place your wrists below your shoulders, thigh bones back, kneecaps lift, chin and chest forward. Pause in this halfway down position. And then exhale, begin to walk the hands back. Extend the crown of your head towards the floor. Lift up on your kneecaps, press back through your thighs, extend the crown of your head down. Perhaps walking your fingertips eventually so they line up with your toes, wrists and elbows, shoulder width distance apart. Perhaps walking the hands back, eventually so they walk off the back edge of your mat, so fingertips actually line up with your heels, perhaps. Okay. Find some way to ground your head, whether it be a blanket or a block. Lift the legs, lift the kneecaps, and become aware of the effects of the shape in your body at this moment. Where does your body, where is your body calling your mind? Where is your body calling for your attention? Occupy those spaces that are most affected by this shape. And it is important to note that poses that create pain in the knees are to be modified or avoided. So at no point should you feel pain or exacerbation of injury in your knees. And that's always a hard call. It's a hard call of what is pain. And we all kind of have a different threshold of tolerance for that, I believe. If you are desiring a floating up into handstand situation, please do that now. Otherwise, continue with the shape as you are in it. Perhaps over the course of this hold, over the course of exploration in this shape, you might have the opportunity to bring your head closer to the floor. One way to access this is by gently bending the knees and then extending the thighs back once again, Jalan,
Janu Bandha, knee. Janu, translated from Sanskrit as knee. Okay, if you're up in the headstand, come on back down. Walk the hands back below the shoulders so you're once again in that halfway lifted position. Bring your left hand below the face. Right hand places a glass of water at your low back. Don't spill the water. Begin to shift your left ribs towards the right. How much can you do that again without using the pressure of the left hand against the floor? How can you revolve around the spine with the strength of your abdominal muscles? You might even bring the fingertips onto the floor, like tent the fingers to rely less on that pressure. And then you could put that hand back down. If the shoulders stack here, you might take the right arm to the sky. If you're not feeling that the shoulders are stacking today, then you might keep the hand on the low back. Gaze down, right hand down, left hand to the glass of water. Don't spill your water. Again, try not to rely on the pressure of the right hand into the floor for that torsion. Is that torque or torsion? I'm no physicist. It occurs to me that there may be a physicist watching this. Revolve your right ribs towards the left. Again, using the abdominal muscles to revolve around the central channel of your spine, rather than this pushing into the floor to push the ribs to the left. Okay, if the shoulders are stacked, left arm might go up. If the shoulders aren't stacked, it might be a better choice to keep the hand on the low back. Gaze down, hands to hips, elbows to the ceiling, draw back through the sides of the waistline. Come on back up, heel toe the feet back together. Okay, kick the butt. And hula the hoop. Hula the hoop in the other direction. Whew, I'm working today. I don't know about you guys. Okay, so let's do one more standing pose before we get down on the floor. Okay, so I'm putting my blocks there, but you don't need to do that because I'm not even going to use them. So feet together at the center of your mat. Tone the muscles of your legs. Roll your shoulders back. Stand in Tadasana. Again, consider a reintroduction to this pose. Consider experiencing this pose anew. Even if you thought you knew this pose, if you thought you had conquered this mountain, you climb Everest and then, you gotta climb it again, right? Right, people? Okay, so mountain, hands together in front of your heart. As you exhale next, hop or step your feet wide apart. Take the outside edges of your feet parallel to the short ends of your mat, arms to the height of your shoulders, tone the muscles up your legs, lengthen down through the tailbone, broaden across the collarbones, and then turn your right toes out 90 degrees. Okay, keep the hips and chest squared forward, look down at the right knee, begin to bend the right knee in the direction of the right toes, sinking the knee, the thigh, to a 90 degree angle. Push the left thigh bone back, ground through the outside edge of the left foot, lift into the left kneecap, extend through the right inner thigh, turn the right palm up, and then as you exhale, reverse your warrior. Inhale, warrior. Exhale, reverse. Inhale, warrior. Exhale, reverse. Stay deeply bent in that front knee. Inhale, warrior. Exhale, reverse. Two more. Inhale, warrior. Exhale, reverse. Inhale, warrior. Exhale, reverse, and hold. Gaze up, deep bend in the front knee, lift, shift weight back to the right heel, lift into the left kneecap, and then back to warrior two. Hips and chest squared forward, ground through the outer edge of the left foot, lift into the left kneecap, look out beyond your right fingertips, and then straighten the right knee.
Hands to hips, right toes turn forward. Square the hips and chest, turn the left toes out. Keep the hips and chest square. Sweep the arms up to the height of your shoulders. Look at your left knee. Keep breathing. Bend the knee in the direction of the toes. Make sure you can see the left big toe at the inseam of your left knee. Lift the right kneecap up, press the thigh back. Square the hips forward. Broaden out through the collarbones. Deep bend in the front knee. Shift weight back to the right outer foot. Left palm up. Exhale. Peaceful warrior. Inhale, warrior two. Exhale, peaceful warrior. Inhale, warrior two. Exhale, peaceful warrior. Inhale, warrior two. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale and hold. Let right arm might go down the right leg, or you might wrap the right arm behind the hips. Right ribs revolve skyward. Sink deep down into left heel. Lift the right kneecap. Janu Bandha. Back to warrior two, keeping the hips relatively stable. Sink into the front knee. Weight in the heel without the knee going beyond the ankle. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Straighten the left leg. Turn all 10 toes forward, hands together in front of your heart. Exhale, hop or step your feet back together. Working hard today. Kick that butt. Hoop the hoop, hula the hoop. Okay, let's meet back. Downward facing doggy. Hands down and forward, hips up and back. Reconnect with your dog pose. Lift the kneecaps up. Let the heels melt down. Left foot towards center, right leg lifts straight up and back. Engage Mula Bandha as you pull the heel towards the hip and then stack the right hip on top of the left hip. Lift into your left kneecap. Janu Bandha, left leg, release the heel down. Squeeze the right knee closed. Get that flexion of the knee. And then look to the top of your mat and lunge your right shin into a pigeon pose. So the right knee is wider than the right hip. The left leg tracks straight back. Let's tuck the toes under for today. Okay. To make this more difficult, the right shin gets closer and closer to parallel with the top of the mat. I just do not feel a need to practice that version of the pose today. So my heel's a little in towards my hip, just based on what I'm feeling, what I'm sensing in my own body. Okay, so if you're seated down on the right hip and the left hip is jacked up away from the floor, then put some height underneath the right hip. Maybe in the form of a block or a precisely folded blanket. Scissor the legs in. So draw the left knee forward, draw the right shin back to square the hips. So we're doing a lot of strength today, a lot of engagement if you have not picked up on that. Okay, scissor the legs in. What? Let's bring the hands to the hips. If not, hands to thigh. Tailbone down, lower ribs in and back. Scissor the legs. And then we're gonna bring the hands forward. Come down into the appropriate expression of this shape for your body today. So you might find a balance between that engagement, the drawing in, the right shin back, the left knee forward, and that expansion out of releasing the hips down. So it might change through the course of the pose. You might kind of pick one way to, an idea that I come back to and I feel is helpful in my worldview is that balance, finding balance does not mean doing equal parts of two things every time. So it's every time you come to pigeon pose, what's going to create balance for you in your practice, or in your life, or in the greater scheme of your in the greater scheme of the universe, is not necessarily finding this perfect perfect balance between engagement and release. One day you might come to the mat and you're going to do this pose really actively, really vigorously, drawing the legs in and really making the emphasis about squaring the hips, and maybe even making the emphasis about getting the right shin parallel to the top of the mat. Other days you're going to approach, to create balance in your practice. It might mean that you're really creating a softness here. So where the shape itself creates the experience, and you're just kind of surrendering to the shape. So where that balance is, it's a moment by moment, day by day. We're always seeking that. I know I'm always seeking that. And it's hard for me not to get caught up in, not to define myself or evaluate myself on what is happening at the exact moment that I'm observing myself. And to recognize that what is happening in the moment is an instance of a much larger spectrum of behavior, of energy or experience. Anybody else feel that? Okay, breathe here. Walk your way back up. So I'm going to lean onto my right hip. This is kind of, I'm not thinking of a great way to transition from our pigeon into a lunge again, but that's what I want you to do. So gingerly find your way into a low lunge with the right foot forward. And then personally, I'm going to put my back knee on a pad. So if your leg is wanting that padding, make that situation happen. Point the left toes, bend the left knee, reach back with the right hand for the outside of the foot. And then once you have a grip on the foot, kick the foot into the hand. So activity today, less about releasing the hips forward and more about pushing the foot actively into the hand. So strengthening the leg in this, strengthening the knee, strengthening the leg in this stretch position. So kick. As much as you don't want to kick, kick the foot into the hand. Left ribs revolve towards the right. Find the breath. Right shoulder blade on the back. And release the foot. Send the hips back into a runner stretch. Right hip pulls back, right heel pulls back. You might round the spine over the right leg again, engage the right knee. You might shift the hips from side to side as you commune with the back of the hamstring muscles. And then come forward and press back, downward facing dog. So we'll do that series on the second side. Push the hands down and forward, reach the left leg straight up and back, knee and toes point down. Heel in towards the hips, squeeze the knees shut, so flex the knee joints. And then stack the hips. Draw in and up, Mula Bandha, lift into the right kneecap, release the right hip down, stack the hips. And then look forward, lunge the left shin towards the top of the mat. So again, gauge your shape here. You may notice that the appropriate propping of the shape might be slightly different from one side to the next. Track the right leg straight back. I'm encouraging the toes to tuck under. for a more activation of the right leg, or at least to start that way. Scissor the legs in, right knee forward, left shin, left knee back. Lengthen the tailbone, possibly hands to the hips. Squeezing in to lift up on the pelvic floor. And then begin to drape the spine forward. So coming down onto forearms, or extending the arms forward, or staying upright. So gauge what feels appropriate for your body today. So again, this this proposal that especially for those of us who have current knee injuries or past knee injuries, that always pain in the knee is something to be avoided. So whatever you need to do to avoid pain in the knee, whether it be propping a lot of height underneath the left hip or even in front of the right hip, or even taking eye of the needle pose, so a similar shape to this but lying on your back where the leg is not weight bearing. Again, consider where your posture might land to create the best balance for your practice today. I do find that question of when to push and when to back off, I find that to be a eternal struggle. A never-ending battle that I face in my life. But hopefully I'm learning to trust myself more, not only through my experience as a parent and just as a person in the world, but also as a yoga practitioner and teacher. Find your way out of this, perhaps by rolling onto your left side. And then meet me again in a low lunge with the back knee possibly on some padding. Knee over the ankle, hands on either side of the front foot, and then point the right toes, bend the right knee, reach back with the left hand for the outer foot. If you can't reach the hand, this is a good place for a strap. Okay. So bend the knee, and then push the foot into the hand. So instead of emphasizing the release of the hips forward, let's today focus on this engaging of the leg, engaging of the thigh, engaging of the muscles around the knee as we lengthen the quads, as we get that IT band stretch. So you might not be able to see it, but I'm pushing the foot into my hand with as much veracity as I can muster at this moment. Then didn't we do something else? Oh yeah, release that. Send the hips back into a runner stretch. Knees, toes towards the ceiling, Janu Bandha. Round the spine over the front leg, pull the left heel back. Perhaps hips shift from side to side, so you're drawing the mouth of a smiley face with your hips. And let's come back for one final downward facing dog of today's practice. Walk out your dog. Shift the hips from side to side, bend the knees. Lower your knees to the floor and let's meet on our backs. So come to lie on your back. Heels into the hips, knees hip width distance. Arms at your sides. So we're gonna do our
our gradual bridge. I did this, it was last week or a couple weeks ago. The idea that we're slowly building a larger bridge. So feet hip width distance, and you might picture a small stream or creek, brook, whatever name you like for a small running thing of water. Push the feet down, lift the hips up. So just making a foot path, a foot bridge to go over that stream. Extend through the knees, ground through the inner feet. Feel a slow opening of the front body. Then lower the hips down. You might walk the feet apart, allow the knees to fall in. Hand to the belly, hand to the heart. Connect with the breath as it moves through the body. Then consider the qualities of your breath as you invite more air in with your next inhale, filling the belly and then the chest. Release more air out with your next exhale, letting the chest fall and then the abdomen. Arms to your sides, feet parallel. We're gonna build our bridge. Push your feet down, lift your hips up, interlace your fingers. Tuck your shoulder blades underneath your chest. There's been some rainfall and your stream has gotten bigger, has graduated to the sides of a river. Ground through the inner feet, lift through the outer hips. Lengthen through the knees, lengthen through the tailbone, squeeze the shoulder blades together behind your heart, tilt your chin towards your chest as you look up the front of your bridge. So is your bridge lopsided? If so, try to build your bridge from the inside. If one side is lower or shorter, can you breathe into that corresponding lung to create more balance from within? Slowly lower the hips down, untuck your shoulders, walk your feet out, let your knees fall together, hand to the belly, hand to the chest. Arrive in this moment, back with the breath, back with the body in repose. Okay, what is going to be your biggest bridge? Are you building up to a wheel or a bound bridge? I like to picture the Golden Gate Bridge. It's really a beautiful bridge over a wide body of water. Okay, so heels in. Option to do either of the poses we've just done, or tuck the hands underneath the heels, grab the outer ankles, or place the hands by the head for wheel. Push the feet down, lift the hips up, tuck the shoulders under, come up into a bound bridge. Or a wheel pose. Inner thighs down, tailbone lengthens. Push out through the feet, push ground through the inner feet, push down and forward with the feet, lift through the outer hips, tone the inner knees so they remain parallel. As you're ready, lower it down, hips to the floor, untuck the shoulders, knees together, hands onto the body. Awareness back in the present moment. Walk your feet together, draw your right knee into your chest, and then push your right leg straight, pushing your thigh bone into the interlace of your fingers.
Reach up through your heel, and with your hand, draw your hip down into the hips. And with your arms, with your hands, draw your femur bone down into the hip socket. Release the right foot down, left leg lifts. Push the left leg into the interlace of the fingers. Reach up through the heel. Janu Bandha, lift into the kneecap. Engage the muscles around the knee. Release. Draw the right knee in and up towards the chest, interlace the fingers, pull the knee up towards the right armpit. Either choose to stay here, extend the left leg straight. Pull it in. Extend through the left heel if you've straightened the leg, ground the left calf, and then release the right foot back to the floor. Draw the left knee in and up towards the left armpit, interlace the fingers, squeeze it in and out. And then either choose to keep the right knee bent or extend the right leg straight, heel down, calf down, pushing out through the sole of the right foot. Foot down, both feet down. Draw the knees into the chest, draw the knees out towards the armpits, and then take hold of the outer edge of the feet for happy baby. Soles of the feet towards the ceiling, shins perpendicular, rock side to side. Feet together, interlace your fingers, widen out through your inner thighs, contract through your outer hips, lengthen down through the tailbone. Let the pressure of the hands, the feet into the hands, pull the arms taut, heads of the arm bones lift away from the floor. And if you've made it here, congratulations. You stuck with the practice, you did something. Hopefully therapeutic for your body as well as your mind. Draw your knees in towards your chest. Wrap your arms around the fronts of your legs. Grabbing wrists, forearms, or elbows. Squeeze in. Tuck your chin to your chest and then curl into a ball. In whatever words you're comfortable with, tell yourself that you love yourself. And then make your way to your Savasana. So, as we did not get to an inversion today, just like last week, I will encourage the legs up the wall pose for Savasana. So if you have a bolster or a blanket, please bring it to the baseboard of an undisturbed wall space, like so. If you have a strap, then make a loop. Make a loop that's about 12 inches in diameter. Have that handy. Scooch your hips to the wall, your bottom to the wall, and then swing your legs up the wall, lifting your hips up onto the folds of your blanket. Take this loop around your ankles so that your legs can release without them falling out to either side of the room. If you don't have a strap, it doesn't take too much effort to keep your feet from falling out. It's just a nice support if you have it. Tuck your shoulder blades underneath your chest. I forgot to say, but if it does happen to be a little cool in the room where you're practicing, it might be nice to put on a sweater or a pair of socks. Just make yourself feel comfortable and supported to the best of your resources. Invite yourself into this shape, into this space, into this opportunity to reflect, to absorb. So once again, presenting this idea of learning, of knowledge, as being kind of a slightly frightening experience when the world opens up in a way that we were not necessarily aware of, or that we were kind of blind, perhaps you could say blind to, and how that can be a frightening place to enter. Because as you learn new things, you might it might kind of break down what you felt was solid ground. It might have this feeling of you know, the ground being pulled out from under you, or not being as stable beneath you. So it's frightening, but I hope that we can have courage and see the beauty in this, the beauty in the not knowing, the beauty in the continuous unfurling of the world in front of us. And that perhaps there is a greater balance at work here. There is, so when things swing one way, eventually or somehow, it's balancing out a past occurrence or a future occurrence. And at this moment, that might not be for us to figure out in this moment. In this moment, is it possible just to reflect? To be an observer of the body at rest? Okay, we'll start to come out of our resting pose by bringing movement back to the fingers and the toes. You might slide your heels down the wall to remove the strap from around your ankles. Extend your right arm as you roll onto your right side, transitioning from our savasana, our corpse pose, into a fetal position. push your way back up to a comfortable seat. Again, consider coming to a cross-legged seat without the assistance of your hands. Reroot, reconnect with the earth as you sit down, grow tall, and bring your hands together in front of your heart. We'll close practice with the single sound of Om. Exhale and inhale. Thank you for your presence, your patience, your hard work throughout today's practice. The light in me recognizes and bows to the light in you. Namaste. Thank you. Thank you for staying on for the class. Let me know if you have any questions, concerns, suggestions for about the class or for future classes. I roughly stuck to the 90-minute prescription today, so tomorrow's going to be a 75-minute class with a lot of the same themes of focus on the knee. So that Bob Dylan quote that I was using from the song My Back Pages, I recommend looking it up. Although I know that song very well, it was really nice to read the lyrics today for me. Okay, so also Bob Dylan's birthday this week, the 24th. So join me again this week or maybe next week, and reach out if you feel like it, or, you know, remain anonymous. That's cool too. Bye.